We have started the lesson sources of food. Yes or no? In the last video, we have learned that food. Is the food is important? Yes, food is very important. We need a food to get energy to do work. Energy is needed to do work. Yes or no? Then we get a nutrients from the food. Different types of nutrients we get from the food, which helps the body for the growth purpose. Yes or no? And it also maintain and repair our body cell. Food also help us to protect us from the diseases. Yes or no? And also we have learned about the sources of food. So which are the sources of food? From where do we get the food? We get mainly the food from plants and animals. Yes, in the last video I have told you about from where do we get the food. Now to prepare any kind of the food varieties, we need a different food items. Yes or no? So such food items when comes together, that food items are called as an ingredients. When the different food items comes together, different food items are required to prepare a varieties of the food or the delicious food. Then we that food items are called as an ingredient. So in today's video, we are going to learn the sources of food. From where do we get? That is from plants and animals. Two plants mostly we get the food from the green plants. We get a food from the green plants. Now I have told you in the last video what things we get from the plants. That is cereals, pulses, vegetable, fruits, oil, spices. This everything we get from the plants. But we do not get from a single plant. Yes or no? Or we do not get from the single part of the plant. We get this all the food items from the different, from the various parts of the plant. Such as root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit. Are you getting this? So from the different parts of the plants we get this food items. So that is the part of the plant which can be eaten. The part of the plant which can be eaten, that is called as an edible part. Are you getting? Now in your textbook this diagram is given. Yes or no? This chart is given for you. That is, now if you will look carefully, the root. Yes, the root, which is the part of the root, which is the underground part of the plant, that is called as a root. Yes, from the root we can get carrot, tulip, radish, sweet potato, which can be eaten. Then the next part of the plant, that is stem, which is the above the ground. So that is called as a stem. Now which part of the plant can be eaten as a stem? That is sugar cane. Next part of the plant is leaves. Now we can say that leafy vegetables we get from the leaves. For example, mint, spinach, cabbage we can get from the leaves. Then the next part of the flower is flower. Now flowers, can you guess which part of the flower, the part of the plant that is flower which can be eaten? Yes, cauliflower, banana flower, pumpkin flower. This part of the plant we can eat as a flower. Then the next is fruit. Now you can get the fruit, number of fruits, for example apple, banana, mango. These are the different varieties of the fruits which are which can be eaten. Yes or no? And they are very healthy. The fruits are very healthy. Then the next part of the plant is vegetable. We get a vegetable from such the different types of vegetables are beans, cucumber, brinjal, peas. We get from this vegetable. These are the plants which from which we can get the fruits, the vegetables. Then there are the different plants such as wheat, rice, kidney beans, cumin. From these plants we get the edible seeds, that is edible part, that is called as a seed, and which can be eaten. Now if we will take the wheat, we can get wheat flour, yes or no? And we can eat chapati, rice. Rice is also a seed from which we can make a different food item such as pulao, rice, yes or no? So they are nothing but they are the seeds. Then the last from your chart, that is nuts, that is cashew nut, almonds. These are the groundnut. These are the parts of nuts. Are you getting edible parts which we get from the plants? Are you getting this? Now next, there are some plants where we can get two or more edible part which can be eaten. For example, now let's go down and just don't go down from the textbook. You just go to the activity number 2. You can see, for example, if we take banana, the plant, from that banana plant we can get fruit as well as flower which can be eaten. Now as you are learning the science, you should also understand the science and you should behave like a scientist. So now, my dear scientist students, just do one activity. Just give attention to your brain and just look out in the surrounding and find such a plants where we can get one or two part of the plants which can be eaten, that is edible part, and find that plants and write in your activity number 2. Okay, just do that activity. Okay, then if you will see the third activity, that is sprouted seed. Many of the students in your mother might be preparing this vegetables such as sprouted seed. So my dear kids, this activity also you will do it by yourself. And what do you have to do? Read that activity carefully, perform that activity. The soaking of the seed, you have to do it by yourself, and you have to send the photo of your sprouted seed to me. Just do this activity. You have to send me the photo of the sprouted seed. Don't lie yourself. What is the procedure? Read it. One day before, you have to keep the seed for in a water, and next day you will get it sprouted out. Are you getting? And you have to send me the photo. Are you getting me? So do this activity. The next source of the plants of the food, next source of the food is that are animals. Yes, before that there are the two MCQs which are given in your textbook. Solve the two MCQs which are given in your textbook. Okay, then animals, the next source of the food is animals. So animals, from animals what do we get? Yes, we get a protein rich food. That is, the first is milk. We get milk from the animal. Yes, milk we get from the cow, buffalo, goat, and And because of the milk, we can prepare the different milk products such as butter, cheese. Yes, and this milk is very, they are rich in proteins, which will help to protect against diseases. Are you getting the proteins? Now in the class 5th, you have learned protein help us to for bodybuilding. Yes or no? For the bodybuilding. Then what things we get from the animals? Milk. Then what we get from the animals? Yes, we get from the animals eggs. Now from which animals we get eggs? Yes, hen. Yes, duck. We get the egg, and eggs are very rich source of protein. They are very rich source of proteins. Are you getting? Then we also get from animal meat. Many of the student or some student might be eating chicken. Yes or no? So this chicken is also the source of protein, which we get protein from it. So the chicken it get from the hen. Meat we get it from the hen. Are you getting? So these are some sources of animals from which we can get, from the animals we can get milk, egg, meat, and also the most important, honey. Honey is also called as in Marathi we can say madh. Now which animal or which bird we can, from which insect we can get honey? Honey bee. We get honey from the honey bee. You might have seen the honeycomb. See, this is a honeycomb. Are you getting? And from this honeycomb, we can get honey, and which is also used as a medicine. This honey is also used as a medicine. And to cultivate this honey, from the honeycomb, or we can say the rearing of the honeybee on a large scale is called, that process is called as in apiculture. That process is called as in apiculture. Now, as you know, this honey is used as a medicine. This honey is used as a medicine. So, to get the honey on the large scale, how we are doing the farming? Yes or no? Rice in the village area we are doing the farming. So similarly, there are some people rear the honeybee. They make a business of honeybee to get honey, and that the rearing of the honey on honeybees on the large scale, that process is called as in apiculture. What it is called? Apiculture. Why they rear the honeybee? To get honey, which is very important, and this is also used as a medicine. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood it. So today activity, you have to complete the activity, do the sprouted seed activity, and send me the photo, and also remove the difficult words and write in your science notebook. Remove the difficult words and writing your science notebook. Also, you have to read the lesson thoroughly. In the next video, we are going to learn what animals eat. What animals eat? Are you getting this? So different. In that, we are going to learn the different on the eating habit. The animals are classified. How the animals are classified? That we are going to learn in the next video. Thank you.